Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Ephesians 4:25 32. Therefore each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to your neighbor, for we are all members of one body. In your anger do not sin, do not let the sun go down while you are still angry, and do not give the devil a foothold. Anyone who has been stealing must steal no longer, but must work, doing something useful with their own hands, that they may have something to share with those in need. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Get rid of all bitterness, rage and anger, brawling and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. Today's title is Do Not Let the Sun Go Down While You Are Still Angry. How then shall we live? This is the title of the famous book written by Francis Schaeffer. Francis Schaeffer was one of the foremost evangelical thinkers of the 20th century. He was a great thinker and theologian who studied the Bible deeply and made a great effort to expound the gospel to the people. But he knew what matters more is the transformed lives. Christians should demonstrate the truth of the gospel through the transformed lives. So he started the community called L'Abri, French for the shelter, in Switzerland, which was later expanded to other European countries such as Sweden. His book How Then Shall We Live? Was also the result of his conclusion that how we live matters more if we convince ourselves as well as others about the truth of the gospel. Apostle Paul obviously shared the same concern about how we shall live. So he goes on to talk about some practical issues of Christian life after he expounded the great mystery that Gentiles now became co-heirs of God with Israel in Christ. How then shall we live? The transformed lives do not necessarily in big and huge change. It starts with small but highly practical things such as how to control anger, how to talk decently, and how to contain the urge to steal what belongs to others. He says it in a very practical earth manner. Therefore each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to your neighbor, for we are all members of one body. In your anger do not sin, do not let the sun go down while you are still angry, and do not give the devil a foothold. Anyone who has been stealing must steal no longer but must work, doing something useful with their own hands, so that they may have something to share with those in need. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. In short, if we have become the people of God by His grace and love, we should demonstrate the significant spiritual transformation within us through concrete and practical changes in our everyday lives. If we have the Spirit of God dwelling in us, we should bear the fruit of the Holy Spirit in us, such as love and patience and forgiveness and unity. So how are you living? Do you live every day in such a way as to prove the great spiritual transformations in you?